Ever since moving to Dallas, I've been real interested in the Kennedy assassination. Now, I don't believe there was any conspiracy. I've looked into every claim they make and found there to be reasonable explanations to all of them. But a lot of people do. And thanks to their persistence, we got a glimpse of some of those things that would have never been revealed. Now, none of those released documents show any evidence of a conspiracy in regards to JFK, but they do show highly secretive CIA operations and documents of some pretty fascinating stuff, some of which were highly illegal. But first, our sponsor, Lucy. It's a new nicotine gum that has been reformulated from the ground up. It is a discreet, better-tasting nicotine gum, so you don't have to step outside to get your nicotine. I just got back from Buffalo, and I would see people standing outside in a snowstorm to smoke. In fact, I can remember my friend coming back to his desk at work, shivering, hands freezing. If we still work together, I'd definitely give him a pack of Lucy. Lucy was started by a couple Caltech scientists to create a significantly better product for today's world compared to the past products. The gum comes in three flavors, wintergreen, pomegranate, and cinnamon. I tried it, and I like the cinnamon the best. We all know smoking is bad for you, and it makes your clothes smelly, so try Lucy instead. Save time and money by using a cleaner alternative with Lucy. Plus, you'll save even more money by using code COVERT to get 20% off any of their products. So give it a try. Go to their website, lucy.co, that's L-U-C-Y.co, and try it for yourself. Warning, this product does contain nicotine. Nicotine is an addictive chemical. One important thing I think to keep in mind here is there's a lot of accusations and conspiracies out there. Now, maybe they're true, maybe they're not, but I like to stick to things that are absolutely known to have happened, 100%. These are all proven, admitted to, or revealed in declassified documents. With that in mind, there are almost certainly more that will never be fully verified, so this is in no way a comprehensive list. These are a few of the real interesting ones that I've come across while reading these documents. One of the biggest ones was the assassination attempts on Fidel Castro, the leader of Cuba. Cuba in the 1950s was friendly with the US, to put it mildly. US corporations and businessmen made a lot of money there, including the mafia with the casinos. When Castro seized power, all that changed. Castro nationalized every industry, including those casinos. Obviously, this hurt the US government, businesses, and the mafia. Now, there are wildly different claims about how many times the CIA tried to assassinate Castro, from a US Senate investigation saying 8, to the Cuban government, which claims over 600. A lot of it comes down to semantics, how you defined an attempt. Most were simply ideas thrown around, without ever any concrete steps taken to actually carry it out. Also, testimonies and documents show that the CIA did not always distinguish between assassinating Castro and their overall goal to overthrow the government of Cuba in general. For example, the famous Bay of Pigs invasion. At first, after Castro took power, the CIA's efforts aimed to discredit him, as he hadn't yet fully cemented his power. That then changed to discussing ideas of assassinating him. But there seemed to be a lot of debate on whether that would actually accomplish their goal of toppling the whole government, as others loyal to Castro would simply take his place, like his brother, Raul, who is actually the current leader of Cuba. This resulted in a larger plan, the Bay of Pigs invasion in 1961. When that failed, the CIA seemed to be back to square one, plotting assassination attempts on Castro, but also again planning another large-scale operation to overthrow the government, Operation Mongoose. The Cuban Missile Crisis a few months later changed that again, and it ended with the US promising not to invade Cuba. President Kennedy's big push to overthrow the Cuban government mostly ended, but that didn't stop all the assassination plots. In fact, the very day Kennedy was assassinated, a CIA officer met with a Cuban asset and gave him a ballpoint pen with poison in it. It then turned out that the asset was actually a plant, working for Castro. Another involved Marita Lorenz, a mistress of Castro. She was persuaded to help the CIA by a man named Frank Sturgis, another real interesting person involved in a lot of clandestine activities, including Watergate. Marita was given poison pills, which she stored in a jar of cold cream. She claimed when she got back to Castro in Cuba and went to retrieve the pills, they had dissolved, ending that attempt. But probably the most famous involved the mafia. The mafia lost a lot of money with the loss of gambling operations and casinos in Cuba, so the CIA figured they could use that. The CIA used somebody named Robert Mayhew, an aide to Howard Hughes, to pretend to be a representative of businesses who suffered from Castro's takeover of Cuba, to contact Johnny Roselli, a high-ranking mafia member. They later supplied pills with poison in them to sneak into Cuba with the connections the mafia still had there. It didn't work, not even close, with some sides saying that the pills never even left the US. That plan was finally abandoned, as the much bigger attempt, the Bay of Pigs invasion, was planned and carried out. There were reportedly other attempts as well, such as exploding seashells and even exploding cigars. The interesting part is the development of these. The CIA's Office of Technical Services develops all sorts of gadgets, gear, disguises, weapons, forged documents, drugs, and poisons. It's pretty much Q Branch from the James Bond movies, but in real life. The next is something called ZR Rifle. Richard Helms, who later went on to be the head of the CIA, and also oversaw many other crazy programs like MKUltra and other mind control projects, testified to Congress that ZR Rifle was originally a project to hire professional assassins for the CIA from the criminal underworld. His statements also indicate that they did in fact hire at least one person, but claimed he put an end to the project for good a few years later. It makes me think of Jason Bourne from reading the documents. And when you consider the attempts on Castro, and the deaths of several other heads of state around that time, like Prime Minister Lumumba from the Democratic Republic of the Congo, Rafael Trujillo, the President of the Dominican Republic, and others, makes you wonder if it really did end, or simply now operates under a different name. These assassination projects were the most secretive, even kept secret from everyone in the CIA itself. The CIA uses what are called 201 files, which is just a personality file containing information on somebody. Anyone can have one. Defectors, radical political party members, congressmen, spies, presidents, even just a plumber who might have a family member living in an unfriendly country. Basically, anyone who could possibly be of interest, no matter how small. Lee Harvey Oswald had a 201 file, which isn't a surprise as he was a Marine and then defected to the Soviet Union and threatened to reveal radar secrets. But these 201 files will contain reports, basic details, newspaper clippings, etc. on an individual and their associates. It is important that these files are accurate, so in the event something happens, they can quickly have information on those involved. Despite this, it was revealed that there have been fake 201 files created to keep the rest of the CIA from finding out. When they typically wanted to keep an operation or individuals involved secret, or had other reasons to limit CIA's employees' access to it, they'd mark the 201 files as restricted. But these phony 201 files are a whole nother level beyond that. This makes you wonder what else was going on, and, unsurprisingly, is popular with the conspiracy theorists to make claims about Oswald being a secret CIA agent. And last is Yuri Nosenko. Nosenko was a member of the Soviet KGB who defected to the US. However, due to many different circumstances, the CIA did not believe he was genuine, but rather a Soviet plant sent to give false information. One reason was that 2 years earlier, another KGB defector told the CIA that the Soviets would send someone fake to try to discredit him. Also, Nosenko did lie. He first stated that he held the rank of lieutenant colonel when he was really just a captain, but he also defected just a couple months after the Kennedy assassination, and told the CIA that he had personally reviewed Lee Harvey Oswald's case file when he was living there in the Soviet Union, and said that in that file, the KGB never tried to recruit Oswald while he was there. This really made things difficult, as if Nosenko was a real defector and telling the truth, it would eliminate the possibility that the Soviet Union was involved. But if he was a plant, that information could be fake. So they needed to find out if he was legitimate. This, however, wasn't easy. The CIA kept him in solitary confinement, barely fed him, with the guards not even allowed to smile at him, let alone talk. They then put him in what has been described as a bank vault, then built a house around that vault. The room was extremely hot in the summer, cold in the winter, they gave him no sheets or blankets, and kept him there 24 hours a day for 1,277 days. In total, he was held for 5 years in solitary confinement before being released. To this day, there is still debate on whether or not he was genuine. The interesting part is memos and documents show the CIA's growing frustration with not getting any closer to finding out the truth. And then later you could tell they simply didn't know what to do with him. They knew they needed to release him eventually, but they thought it was also dangerous. So they just kept delaying and delaying for 5 years. And again, we only know about this because they were forced to release these files. And there are countless more crazy CIA stories and operations that we know are 100% true. Not just half-baked guesses, assumptions, or conspiracy theories. Way too many of them to name here. If you are interested, definitely go over and check out the declassified JFK files. You can find them on archive.org, then sort by agency and find the CIA ones. There's lots of fascinating stuff. This stuff again was never expected to be revealed to the public, and likely wouldn't have if it wasn't for these conspiracy theorists. So it really makes you wonder how much more is going on today.